Mr. Reji Pillai, COO NHR, City Gold Media. Sir, may I request you to please join us on the stage?
I would like to request Dr. K.K. Velluri, Director of BITM, to welcome Mr. Reji Pillai with a bouquet. Thank you, sir. May we now call upon Mr. Ayush Mishra, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, to introduce Mr. Reji Pillai.
A very good morning to one and all present. I have the privilege of introducing our guest speaker for this session, Mr. Reji Pillai. Mr. Reji Pillai is currently COO, Operations and HR at City Gold Entertainment Limited. Reji sir is a human resource and business operation professional with extensive experience in operations and HR functions. His area of expertise include performance management, training, payroll, strategy development, operational management, policy and procedure, people management, workforce management, brand expansion, etc. Prior to joining City Gold, Reji sir has held leadership positions as Fair Deal Productions, Unnati Success Academy, Manav Nesvi Infrastructure Private Limited, etc. Reji sir is an alumni of University of Sunderland and the Gujarat University. Sir, now I request you to enlighten us with your words of wisdom. The dice is all yours, sir. Thank you.
Hello. Hello, can you hear?
Yes, sir.
Great. Fine. Good afternoon to all the students of Balaji. First of all, I'd like to thank you, the fraternity, the students, members, for inviting me to share my experience regarding my career and what the future skills looks and what is required for the successful corporate career growth. I'll just give a very brief background of what I was earlier introduced. I'm not kind of a typical presentation guy, so I don't have presentation, so don't worry about it. Right? I believe in live experiences. I believe what I learned from my life throughout my career. Right? To begin with,
hello?
Yeah. To begin with, just a second. Can I have that mic? I prefer that. To begin with, lots of people think communication skills, management skills, that's the very important aspect for a successful career. But what really believe, what really grows, helps you grow in your corporate is your adaptability. How comfortable are you in adapting to the scenarios around you, within you, and in you? If you can adapt to your scenarios, it will help you grow. People believe joining big corporates is the first stepping stone to the success. But what I believe is basically starting at the bottom line of a new organization is the first step to your success. I started my career with an organization which had a turnover of just 5 CR against an company which had a turnover of more than 120 CRs. I grew from a position as an administrative assistant to a CEO within a span of 10 years. That's what taught me my life being a live experience. I've been into diversified field, I've been into banking sector, I've been into telecom, I'm with telecom currently also. And what made me grow is your ability to recon the opportunity that you have to grow, right? Secondly is your leadership skills. What is leadership basically? Let's focus on what is leadership. Is it just about running a team? Is it just about making your teams log for you? Or is it about just growing your team so that you can be benefited in your career? Anyone can answer this? Okay, close. Anyone else? Can anyone answer what's leadership? Which area? Yeah, please. Actually, that's what I was looking for.
Yeah.
Great, perfect. So leadership is about being responsible and being accountable for your actions as well as for your team's actions. I have seen lots of people, okay, if a team member has failed, it's his fault, it's not my fault. Why? Because you are the leader, you are the person that who has groomed, you are the person who has shown him the light. You are guiding angel for that team member. And if your team member fails, it's your failure. So you should be accountable for what your team member has failed for. So that is the leadership. That's what we are called as a true leadership. Right? The second is delegation. Delegation of work. When people take a project on hand, for example, if I say that we took a project for launching Jio in Gujarat 2 years down the line, right, we currently have a team that is delegated with each nitty-gritty of the entire project. So I have a team of 150 people, right from laymen, laying the cables, underground cables, setting up the towers, setting up the system, setting up the networks, right? Everything has been delegated. But what after delegation? Do you follow up? Or do you be on their back every time, just asking, okay, what's the progress? No, delegation means you delegate a work to a team member and put a deadline, that's all. Let him perform. Once he performs, you perform. And once you perform, the company performs. That's what delegation is. Third, the third aspect of a successful career in corporate is how competitive and how close are your competitors are. How many of you within your batch spend time with your competitors? How many of you spend time with your competitors? All of us, okay. So what you learn from your competitors? Pardon? Accepting, okay. Strength, okay. Weakness, okay. Improve yourselves, okay. Pardon? Challenges, okay. I believe all the points that you guys told me, the most important point is criticism. How many of you take criticism from your competitor positively? Because that's what basically makes you grow. The moment you put a negative thought on your criticism, you will be a failure. The moment you put a positive thought on your criticism, you will be a successful person in your career, personally as well as professionally. Fourth, apart from that, how many of you keep your commitments? What do you mean by keeping commitments? Sabne haath uncha kar diya link. What do you mean by keeping commitments? One at a time. One at a time. Okay. Pardon? Honoring the words. How many times is possible in a professional career that you are able to keep your commitments? I would like to know from Amrish. Okay. That's very close. In a corporate career, the average industry standard of any individual, whether it's a junior level officer or a senior person in a management, the average percentage of commitment meant is 35%. And the industry standard has been published. If you look at the business world, in the January edition, it was published that corporates miss their business targets because they fail to honor their commitments. Why? Why it does happens? Because it basically, they people who don't understand the analytics, they overshoot their commitments. They always overshoot the commitments. It happily happens with the operational aspects, the marketing aspects, and the bottom line, the customer service aspects. How many of you have ordered from Amazon? Everyone, okay. How many of you got your products on time as per the commitments? Before, okay. Now, how many of you order from Snapdeal? And how many of you have got the orders delivered before time? After time? Okay. So, now I think you're very clear about what I mean by commitment, right? Okay. So, commitment very clearly plays a very big role. The reason is that everyone likes to commit. Everyone likes to commit. The moment you come out of your post-graduation having MBA degree in your hand and say, go to an interview and say that, okay, sir, I'm passed out from this XYZ college. This is what my expected salary is and I can commit X amount of revenue. Right? 3 months, okay. The corporate will look at you. 4th month, they will call you on the table and say, you commit X amount, X percentage of revenue, and you're sitting at A. Why? Any idea why that happens? Because we don't do our research on the industry. We don't do the current scenario industry research. It always happens, whether it's marketing, whether it's telecom, whether it's operations, whether it's administrative, whether it's customer service. It always happens, people overshoot their commitments. Second thing, punctuality with commitment plays a very key role. If you give a time and if you commit to be at some meeting or to meet someone, try to be there. But if you are not, communicate to them. So that they are aware that you are stuck for XY reasons or you are on the way. Amrish, tell me one thing. How many times you've been to an appointment, you're going for meeting a client, you give them an appointment, you're on time, but the client is not there. What does it impacts you? Right? So that's what happens. So once you commit, once you say, okay, you're going to meet XYZ person and you be there on time. Be honor the commitment. If you cannot honor, postpone it to another date or time because commitment, everyone's time is value. Everyone values their time. Everyone has a work to be completed on priority. I think I'm boring you guys because someone's yawning over here. Okay, after commitment, is gathering. How many of you gather together? How many of you gather together out of your subject preview, out of the campus, and discuss things which are not related to your careers? How many of you do? Sab karenge, students pe to sab karenge. Let me ask the fraternity members. Sir, aap gather hote ho bar? Amrish, what about you? Do you meet with other competitors' friends outside your work? Do you gather with other industry peoples outside your work? Why do you do that? Great. Network yourself. Networking helps you grow. Networking gives you opportunity to identify your interest in the market. Because networking is something that you will not get from your college. Networking is something that you not get from your current job. Networking is something that will always happen out of your working hours or office. Why does chaiwalas are so prosperous in India than any other country? Why is chaiwala prosperous about in India than any other country? Chai pe charcha, right? That's what. Chai pe charcha karo. Table pe charcha mat karo. Chai pe charcha karo, kyunki wohi aapko growth degi. That's only the way you're gonna grow. I've been in the industry, I've been in the corporate world for a long time. But in the last 5 years, what I realized is a closed door meeting yields 10% result, while you do an open door meeting or outdoor meeting yields 30% results. The deals are closed outside the office, not in the office. Amrish agrees, right? Office mein baith ke deal close nahi hota hai. Chai pe baitho, coffee pe baitho, deal close hota hai. If you go to Bombay, which I have seen, because when I travel to Bombay a lot, and I have very couple of good clients in Bombay, and whenever I go to them, they never invite me to their office. I was curious. First time, they invited me to a CC day at Nariman Point. I said, okay, we'll meet up. Second time, again, CC Nari Point. I said, okay, fine. Third time, again I went there, CC day, Nari Point. So I was just curious, why this guy is not taking me to his office? So I asked him. His name is Mr. Sarbarjit Balla, and he is basically the PE investor, right? And he is investing into the windmill project that currently I am working on. So I asked him, why, sir, you are not inviting me to the office? Out of curiosity, and he said, sir, office mein agar main aapko bulaunga, to apni 10 minute ki meeting 1 ghante chalegi aur result zero aayega. So I said, why? And then he said, it's simple. I'm a VP of an organization. I head the finance, right? If I'm in office, I get 10 calls in a span of 30 minutes. To answer that calls, we have to delay our meeting, right? And the entire subject goes for a toss. Hum coffee day mein mil rahe, discuss kar rahe, aur hum 90% ke solution pe aake baithe. Ye mere office mein nahi ho sakta. That's what I learned, that when you are doing the business, when you are communicating, when you are meeting someone, always try for your, whether it's marketing related, whether it's sales related, whether it's operational related, try to meet the competitor, try to meet the senior persons outside the office, because that will help them to open up. Because there are set rules in the entire corporate industry, there are set rules in the entire, any organization, how to behave and how to communicate to the people you meet within the office. But there are no set rules when you're meeting them outside the office. What happens? Because when you meet them outside the office, you make them feel comfortable. You will yourself become more comfortable in speaking to them. As I was interacting with some of the students in the morning at the office downstairs, I found them, they were a bit tensed, right? Like they were like standing like attention, army with their attention. Right? Always be relaxed, irrespective of where you are, how you are, what level you are, always be relaxed in your life. Because relaxation helps you do wonders. Relaxation helps you do wonders. Let me ask you a very simple question. How many would like to join startups and how many would like to join corporates? Okay. Why startups? I'm turning this entire presentation, entire lecture speak into question answer session because I don't want you to get bored with the slides and everything. So let's keep it to a very Q&A sessions, interaction. So we'll be able to make it very quick, very easy, and we'll have a lot more questions and answers related than the present, because I know lots of speakers have been here. They have given lots of topics, a lot of points, a lot of skills areas, which I don't want to go again and again. So why startups? Can someone pass mics to the students over there? Why startups? Okay. Exposure.
So it tells us like from the very beginning, like how small deals are done. And from that, like how big deals are done. Basically, from one customer to the biggest investors, it tells an idea how to convince them.
Okay. Exposures, ideas, ground root. I'll say that it's a ground level.
Sir, because in startup, I will get to know I'll get to know all the people within the organization. Because in case if I'm in a huge organization, I might be limited to my team only. But within startup, I might interact with the CEO, other managers as well. And I will get to know all the information about what's happening within the organization.
So it's open chain, open communications.
Yes. Thank you.
In startup, you can learn a lot. You can work anywhere, in any sector. Whereas in big company, you have a specific area where you have to work. And again, the bitter experiences teach you more than the sweet ones.
Right. Good. So that's why startups plays a very important role. I, like in the morning when I was coming to your college, I was speaking to Nitin and Anamika, who am I, Edo Deor, and I was telling them that I come across a lot of students who want to join corporates. Why? Because they just want a hefty pay package. I've seen students who come out from colleges with an MBA degree and say, okay, I've done MBA from this college, right? And this is what my salary expectations are. So, but the one question that they don't ask, that the students don't ask in this, in the coming generation is basically, are they worth of what they're expecting? Amrish is laughing because he knows what I'm talking about, what I'm going to. Because are they worth for what they are asking? I'll tell you, I'll give a nice example on it. Last year I did a campus placement for BK Institute of Management, which is one of the premier management institute of Gujarat. To get into that college for management, MBA management, is tough. I came across a student, I won't reveal his name, and he came to me. He had a good grade. He scored very good, and now I was interviewing for the post of a operations manager for an organization which I'm very closely associated as a family. And I took an interview and I asked him, the first question I asked him, what's your expected salary is? What package are you expecting? He told me 5 lakhs. And I asked him to justify. The reason is, sir, I have done BK Institute from MBA. In 2 years, I have put 15 lakh, so I will ask you for 5 lakh. So I gave him an offer. I gave him an open offer. 3 months, I'll pay you a salary of 7 lakhs. I'll pay you a salary of 7 lakhs per annum, provided if you give me a return of 70 lakhs of revenue. To top of it, I told him, you bring me a revenue of 70 lakhs, I pay you 7 lakhs per annum, plus I pay you another 3 lakhs as an additional bonus. And he said, why like that? I said, go to the market and see how many MBAs from BK are doing a job for a salary of 3 lakhs. It's simple. Know your worth in the market before you expect. Know your worth. And to learn the harsh reality, the best way is to start from a ground level. The best way is to start at a ground zero level. Whenever I go to colleges to share my experience or to enrich the students, I give them an assignment, and most of them do, and they come back to me. My current assistant, who is assisting me in my entire project, she's a pass out from Symbiosis. And when she came to me 2 years ago, I gave her a simple project. I said that I'm giving you 10,000 bucks, right? And I want you to live the life of a queen. You prove to me that you are worth the life of a queen, and I'll pay you the package you asked for. Bombay mein 10 rupees mein tum jee sakte ho. Can you survive in Bombay in 10 rupees? Per day 10 rupees. You need to learn to survive in 10 rupees also. And you need to learn to survive in 1,000 rupees also. 5 रुपए का वड़ा होता है, 5 रुपए का नींबू पानी मिलता है स्टेशन पे, तो ट्रैवलिंग का क्या करोगे? वन टाइम अटर. सो दिस इज व्हाट बेसिकली यू नीड टू नो योर वर्थ, बिकॉज इफ यू कैन नॉट सेल योरसेल्फ टू द पीपल और द पीपल्स इन द इंडस्ट्री, यू कैन नॉट बी अ सक्सेसफुल. यू नीड टू नो योर वर्थ. Amrish, can I ask you one single question? How long have you been with Indus Bank?
Pardon? 3 years.
Prior to that? So overall banking experience? Okay. Insurance. Right? Okay. So if you say 13 years, it took you 13 years to reach where you are, right? How many times have you feared the failure? Right? Great. How many of you are confident that you can overcome your fears? I'm asking to the students. Great. Okay, let me put a scenario. If you get a good job in a corporate, which I know you will get it down the line, 5 years into your corporate career, and if I ask you that you're thrown out of your current position, go back, I'm not going to pay a single penny, and start from ground zero, how many of you can do it? Very few. Why? The fear. See, what happens is basically in India, bacha jab paida hota hai na, to maa baap ki expectation badh jate. So when a child is born in India, the expectations from that kid grows, right? The moment he passes the junior college, the expectations of the society grows. Right? The moment he passes out from the senior college and the management college, the expectations from his parents, societies, and the college from which he passed out grows. Tag lag jata hai. Ke, I need to perform. The peer pressure starts from day one. steps out into the field from the management college. For students who are taken marketing, don't forget to take the contact number of Amresh. The simple reason is saying that in the entire marketing industry, the only industry that faces hardship and the only industry that is the toughest industry to grow, survive and live is insurance. Insurance is the only industry that is very tough to survive. If you can survive in a marketing position in an insurance industry for 3 years, you can survive any industry. And I can bet my entire experience on it. Operations, students who are into operations and who are into technology, telecom, right? Get a job where you get a hands-on experience on a site where you don't have a network, where you don't have the facilities of your home, and where you don't have the facility of spending recreational activities, getting yourself free from the pressure. Spend 3 years on an outdoor site, spend 3 years from a site where you are cut off from the world, and trust me, when you come back after 3 years from such a site and put yourself back in the market, people will grab hold of you and pull you back where they want to be. And the students for HR? How many HR students are here? Oh, so the entire HR is this side. Okay. Silence. And for the students who are doing their majors in HR, bloody get your ass into recruitment. Spend 3 years in recruitment and prove you can hire any top notch, you can buy any toppers from any organization, you can poach any senior management from any corporates and put them onto a startup with a low package, you are successful. And if you cannot do that, forget HR. I'm coming to each and every. Right? Okay, now which industry is left? One at a time. Finance, right? Okay. People in finance, whoever does the major in finance, get me a loan of 1000 CR with a market cap of 500 CR and with a guarantee of 200 CR. And I guarantee you will be successful. I know Amrish is laughing because that's not possible. Right? ID? International business? Silence. For international business students, something I will share about my experience. I got associated with UTI prior to it turned into Axis in 2007. I was very close to Lal Singh, who is the current circle head of Axis Gujarat. My batchmate from MBA UK, I did my MBA from UK, and my batchmate Charmin Udwadia, who was the CEO, right? She came to me and said that we are converting UTI into Axis. And I said, why you want to convert UTI into Axis? Because it's successful, it's growing. I said, just we want to do it. I said, okay, fine, we'll do it. So she put me a challenge with my expertise in HR. She put me a challenge that I have to basically roll out a program that will convert the existing staff to a pay grade that is in line with other international banks? I said that's not going to happen. And she said, why? I simply said, if you want to shut down your bank, you can do that. And if you want to keep your bank rolling, don't change what's happening. Just say the name and let it flow. So that's where international business came into play. For international business students, right? Get Goldman Sachs on your profile and you'll be worth a diamond in the industry. Why I said Goldman Sachs? Because the entire conversion from UTI to Axis happened through Goldman Sachs, and I had an opportunity to work with them on the entire project. That's how I got associated with Axis. So if you have Goldman and Sachs on your profile, on your resume, 3 years down the line, market will start calling you at the rate you demand for. So this is what basically success is about. It's about evaluating yourself. It's about creating a brand value of yourself. Each and every single one. The honorable directors, the faculty members, the students, all of you are brand yourself. You are a brand. It's just that you need to have your value evaluated. I'll tell you, in today's scenario also, even though I'm a CEO, even though I'm a director of a couple of companies, I still go for a job interview. Why I'm going for a job interview? Pardon?
To learn new things for better salary.
No. Why should I go for better salary? My current annual package is 30 lakhs per annum, plus perks. So why should I go for a better? Why should I go for a better package? No. I go to evaluate myself. Because learning never stops. Learning happens every single day, every single moment, every single second. Learning never stops. Never think yourself that you're master of everything. Never think yourself that you're master of everything. Always think yourself as a student. You're still a learner. You still learn. If I'm not wrong, even ma'am learns every single day from my experiences. Everyone learns, irrespective of their position. Everyone learns from day one. Everyone learns from day one. Every day-to-day activities you learn. You learn from your juniors. You learn from your seniors. You learn from your peers. You learn from your neighborhood. You learn from people who are on the footpath also. You know, the most happiest person, people, the most happiest people in the world are the ones that who don't have anything to bother about. You know why? Because they are happy, they are competent with what they have. How many of you have goals in your life? How many of you want to retire at the age of 45? 45. Okay.
Can you pass the mic to this gentleman over here?
Yeah. So you want to retire at the age of 45?
Yes, sir.
So what's your plan? Share to your fellows, how you plan to retire at the age of 45?
So I have lot of money that time, that's why.
How are you going to make a lot of money? How are you going to make that? Very simple question. How are you going to make that?
That time I don't have idea, sir.
So, everything in your entire career, your entire success, personal, professional, everything lies on a one key aspect. That's why I'm taking it as a point to be noted the last, one key aspect, planning. How many of you do plan? How many of you plan? I want to ask Amrish because he always plans. He's still planning in his mind. Kiske baad kya karna hai? Yahan khatam karke mereko kahan hai meeting mein jana hai. Right? How many of you plan? Okay. How many of you stick to the plan? Okay. See, students, planning is as important as sticking to it. Drawing a roadmap to your plan to achieve your goals, which you have planned, is very important. If you really want to retire at the age of 45 with lots of money, you have to do the reverse calculation. You have to count your age as of now. What are you going to do after 5 years? 5 years, 5 years, 5 years till you age 45. Right? So, what to do your package at the age of 45 so that you can retire? So, after 45, you got another 20 years of life. With 10 years of liability, financial liability, and for 5 years of your grandson's liability, put in that way. So 15 years of liability, how are you going to plan it at the age of 45? So that's very important. So you should always plan your future from top to bottom rather than from bottom to top, because that's what I've done. That's what I've done. When I started my career at the age of 19, as a part-time computer assistant somewhere, part-time I was doing my college, and when I started my career, and when I saw my father, because I come from a very middle-class family, we are basically farmers from Kerala. My background is I'm basically a farmer from Kerala. So my father started his career with Reliance, and I seen him struggle. So when I started working, I realized I don't want to work like him till he worked at the age of 55. So I put a map. The day I graduated, I put a date on my calendar, that's 6th of April 2025, I'll hang up my boots. I won't work. I'll resign from every single post that I hold, and I'm stick to that. I'm already in process of that, coming closer to that deal. So I planned my reverse. Okay, 25 mein agar main chhodunga to mere ko kitne liability rahengi mere paas, usko kaise cover karunga, uske baad how I'm going to incur my expenses, how I'm going to cover my expenses. I cannot be dependent on anyone, no. So that's how I started diversifying myself. Though I'm a core HR guy, I'm into telecom. I diversified into telecom, I diversified into media. I have an ad house where I do the ad suits. I have diversified myself into various businesses. I have an organization which is purely into training. So diversifying yourself is always important. Also acquire additional skills that you require to grow. If someone has done major in marketing, don't just go with marketing, acquire some additional skills, because that will always help you to grow. Because coming down the line, next 10 years, 15 years, the industry is going to be diversified and will be looking for multi-talented people. They will be looking for people who can be multi-talented, who can do multiple tasks, and who can take the responsible of multiple activities, not just a single position. As of today, even is happening today also, most of the banking sectors. Right? पहले बैंकिंग में ऑपरेशंस होता था तो बोलते हमको तो क्या है खाली बस पासबुक में एंट्री मारो कैश लो डू द डिपॉजिट दैट बेसिक ऑपरेशंस बट टुडे प्राइवेट सेक्टर में अमरीश आल्सो शेयर्स हिज एक्सपीरियंस ऑन इट लेटर ऑन टुडे even in operation, banking operations, sales has become mandatory. Sales has become mandatory. You are selling yourself. Whether it's operations, whether you are into service, whether you are into finance, whether you are into IB, whether you are into IT, whether you are into HR, you are selling yourself. Because if you can't sell yourself, you can't sell anything. Thumb rule of your life. So diversify yourself into skills. My last point is, don't be afraid of losing anything in your life. Don't be afraid of losing anything in your life. Always take the opportunity to lose things in your life, because you're young. You have another 10 years in your life to stabilize your entire life. You have 10 years to stabilize your entire life. Don't be afraid. I've seen lots of students who join corporates, and when they get an opportunity to showcase their skills to a smaller organization, they're afraid of socioeconomic status within the society. But I think that has to be overcome through the society, by the society, and within ourselves. You should be able to make a decision of yourself. How many of you have joined management studies because it's the requirement of your society? One student, he's very honest. You'll grow, definitely you'll grow. So, what I'm saying is basically, be true to yourself. Don't bother what society thinks. If you are happy doing what you are doing, do it. If you are not happy, don't do it. Because at the end of the day, I believe, and this is my personal opinion, no offenses to any industry or the society, it's my very personal opinion, it's my personal experience, that society is not going to stand with you when you are in a pool of mud. You have to pull yourself out of it. I remember when I completed my postgraduation from UK and I came back because of my father's ill health. I went to Bombay and I didn't have a job. I didn't know anyone. So I went to Bombay to start up my career again. And for the first 7 days, I slept up Trailblazer platform. With 5,000 in my pocket, eating vada pav every day. Using the railway platform and the waiting area, waiting room as my small house, I started again with UB over there. At that time, I realized that society will never be there to help you. It's my personal experience I'm saying, because when I came back from UK, all my relatives, the entire my family, they started criticizing me that why you came back. It's a father, theek hai, medical attention de denge. Heart surgery ho jayega, toh theek ho jayenge. Wapas kyun aaya toh? Because when I came back from UK, I was working with Sainsbury's and Boots Alliance as a senior position. I was running well. I had a house over there. I left everything and came just for my father. But I started my career back again. So it's not society who's going to help you. It's you who's going to help you to grow. So that's all I have to say. I think I have said my views, and if my speech has made you boring or sleeping, I do apologize for that. Thank you. Thank you for the time wasting.
Thank you, sir. Now the house is open for further question and answers.
I think most of the questions and answers have been answered already. That's good. That's the reason I made it as a Q&A interactive session rather than a presentation session.
Thank you, sir. Sir, you taught us today that it is very important to start from the scratch. Agility and adaptability is a must. delegation finally pays off to good results. One must imbibe the spirit of competitiveness and take criticism positively. You have enriched us with your words of wisdom today, sir. We look forward to many more such interactions on and off the campus.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Dr. Rashmi Mahajan, Deputy Director, BITM, to present memento to Mr. Reji Pillai.
Mahima, 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 Mahima.